Good morning, students. Today our topic is Microsoft Word, and in this lecture we are going to discuss some question answer related to Microsoft Word, which may be asked in your examination. And these questions belongs to basically the computer application class 9 book written by Sumit Arora. So let's start. First of all, what is a word processor? Give some example. So a word processor is a software. Word processor is a software which provides a general set of tools. Which provides a general set of tools for entering, for editing, and formatting text that permit operations to perform for more rapidly and more efficiently. An example of word processor are WordStar, MS Word, OpenOffice, and OpenOffice.org Writer. These are the some example of word processor. So in short, first of all, three main things are there. Word processor is a software. Second thing, it is a tool for entering, editing, and formatting text. And third and the most important thing is that by using word processor, we use our work more rapidly and more efficiently. And some example of word processor are WordStar, MS Word is most common word processor, OpenOffice, ORG.Writer. So these are the some word processor. Okay. Now, what do you mean by the term word wrapping? Second question is word wrapping. Okay. Wait a minute. The placement of text going past the right margin to the next line is called the word wrap. Placement of the text going past the right margin to the next line is called the word wrap. And this is one of the feature which is there in nearly all word processor, and it is by default on. So the question, our question is, what is or what do you mean by what do you mean by word wrapping? So placement of text going past the right margin to the next line. Going past the right margin to the next line is called the word wrap. I think it is clear to all of you. All the these two are the most important words that are mostly used in terms of any word processing tools. So word processor and word wrap. Next, our question is, while entering text with writer, which keys mark the end of a paragraph? While entering the text with writer, especially where in this question we are just talking about the open office writer, that is a word processor. So question is asked as, while entering text with writer, which keys mark at the end of the paragraph? So the enter key mark at the end of the paragraph, and the paragraph mark is shown in the extreme right of the line. Okay, extreme right to the line. So to end of the paragraph, we use just press enter key. By using the enter key, you can end your paragraph in writer. Our next question is, what are the non-printing characters and how will we able to see them in writer? Here we just talk about the software writer. Okay. So the characters which do not appear on the paper when we print a document are known as non-printing characters. As the name says, non-printing character. The characters which are not printed when we just give a print command is called the non-printing characters. And these are spacebar, enter key, tab key. These are the three main characters that are not printed. And we will be able to see them through the show hide button. Show hide button. Okay. So we will be able to see the show hide button available on the standard toolbar. So you can see them on the standard toolbar, and the shortcut key in the writer for the same is Control plus F10 to see the non-printing characters. Okay, to see the non-printing characters. Let us take another question. What are the margins in word processing terminology, and how many different types of margins are available? So the distance from the text to the paper edge is called the margin. This is an important question and may be asked in examination, that distance from the text to the paper edge is called the margin. Okay, and paper also some portion called the top, bottom, left, right is the blank. So the question is asked as, what are the margins in word processing terminology and how many different types of margins are available? So here we have to not only to tell discuss about the margin, but also question is asked about the type of the margin. So the, as far as the margin is concerned, the distance from the text to the paper edge is called the margin. Okay, and there are different types of margin. These are top, bottom, left and right. So these are the different types of margins. So there are basically, we can say that four types of margins, and these are top margin, bottom margin, left margin and right margin. Our next question is, define indentation. So what is indentation? The distance between the, I think now the question related to margin is clear to all of you. So now our next question is, define indentation. This is also a very important question. And let us see, the distance between the page margin and the text boundary. The distance between the page margin and the text boundary is called the indent. Okay, it's called the indent. And the process of providing is, it is called the indentation. So two words are here, what is the indent and what is the indentation. Process of indent is called the indentation. What is indent? The distance between the page margin and the text boundary of page margin and the text boundary is called the indent. Okay, our next question is, what is mean by text alignment and how many text alignment are there? Especially some sometimes question are asked related to justify alignment. So here question is simply asked, what is meant by text alignment. Okay, so text elements refer to the text layout within a paragraph with respect to document margin. For example, left, right, center and justify. Left, right, center and justify. And the question is asked related to justify. What is the mean by justify alignment? So equal amount of space is left on both of the side, on as left as well as on right hand side, is called the justify alignment. Okay, so these are the four types of alignment. In center, text is written in the center. In left alignment, text is written on the left hand side, and in right alignment, text is written on the right hand side. So these are the different text alignments. So we can align a text in any word processor such as the Microsoft Word. So in which different types of alignments are there? These are left alignment, right alignment, center alignment and justified alignment. So our next question is, what do you understand by the term clipboard? Very important question. What do you mean understand by the term clipboard? So the clipboard is that temporary storage. First of all, it is a temporary storage. Okay, so it is the clipboard is a temporary storage area which is used for keeping the cut copy text graphic, and this cut copy text graphics can be used for copying, pasting it elsewhere. So as you know that the shortcut of the copy is Control C, and shortcut for cut is Control X. These are the two different operations, and when we want to paste it in anywhere in a document or in another document, that shortcut is Control V. So sometimes what happens that we basically select area using select area or select a portion of a document, okay, using select command or using basically Control A command. So we can select a particular area. After that we want to make a Control C operation. It means we can just make a copy of it, and if we want to paste it anywhere in the Word document, and even you close that document, you are able to paste it anywhere in another document. Okay, means where you just select the data or perform the copy operation, now you are able to paste it anywhere in other document or in the same document also. If that document is also not open, you are basically pasted it anywhere in another document, then it is also possible. It is possible because of the memory, because of a memory that is called the clipboard, and that is a temporary memory. It basically provides you some space when you just perform a cut or copy operation. So that data goes to that clipboard, and now you are able to perform cut, and you are able to perform paste operation on any Word document. So first of all, clipboard is a memory. Second, it is a temporary memory. And third, basically when we perform cut or copy operation, then that data save into or that then that data goes into clipboard. So these are some points related to clipboard. Next is, what is the difference between copying and moving a block of text? There are two operations, copying and moving. So moving block means removing or cutting a block of text from one location and inserting it at another location. That is a move operation. Means you move from one place to another place. In similar manner, in Word, when you move from one place to another place, then it simply means that that data goes from one place to another place. Okay, so that is a moving block operations. And second is copying. So copying text means making a copy, inserting a copy of block at another location. That means that now you have a data at two different places, not only at a single place as in the case of moving a data, but you have a data at two different places. Okay, and leaving the original unchanged. In that case, original data is unchanged. And moving means changing the location. Copying means replicating the text. So in simple words, we can say that moving means changing the data location. We just change the data from one location to another. While copying means we just replicate, or means we make a duplicate copy of it, okay, of the text. So that is the difference between copying and moving of a block of text. Next question is, what is meant by formatting a document? So the general arrangement of the text is called the formatting. And formatting provides document a neat and more legible outlook, and it makes a document presentable. So the general arrangement of the text is called the formatting, and the formatting provides document a neat and more legible outlook. Okay, so in simple words, we can say in a single line that it makes a document presentable. That is the main purpose of formatting. Next question, which is very important. What do you mean by spell check of a document in a word processor, and how is it actually done? So spell check means applying the spell check feature of the word processor in a document. It helps in producing error-free document. Spell check in a word processor is actually done with the help of available dictionary. So what happens most of the time, that in a word processor, we write a letter, suppose, and there are some spelling mistakes. Then Microsoft Word or other also softwares are suggest the correct spelling. Okay, and even if you duplicate a word continuously two times or more than two times, it also indicate that. So the spell checker option basically check the spelling throughout your word document, and not only it find out the wrong spelling, but it also suggest the correct spelling of that word. So using a spell check word, you are able to see the wrong spellings of the different words, and you are able to correct them also. So that is the purpose of the spell check फंक्शन स्पेल चेक, स्पेल चेक इन वर्ड प्रोसेसर, एंड दिस इज़ डन बाय विद द हेल्प ऑफ अवेलेबल डिक्शनरी. एंड यू आर ऑल्सो एबल टू एड सम वर्ड इफ़ यू वॉन्ट इन दैट डिक्शनरी. सो नेक्स्ट टाइम वैन दे फेस सम टाइप्स ऑफ वर्ड विच आर नॉट इन दैट देयर डिक्शनरी, दे सजेस्ट दे टेक इट इट एज इट इज एज यू गिव टू इट. नेक्स्ट इज वाट डू मीन बाई प्रिव्यूइंग ए डॉक्यूमेंट. वाट डू मीन बाई प्रिव्यूइंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट. सो पेज प्रिव्यू मीन्स प्रिव्यूइंग ए डॉक्यूमेंट प्रायर टू बींग प्रिंटेड. ओके, पेज प्रिव्यू मीन्स प्रिव्यूइंग ए डॉक्यूमेंट प्रायर टू बी प्रिंटेड, दैट इज व्यूइंग टू सी हाउ द डॉक्यूमेंट विल एक्चुअली लुक वैन प्रिंटिंग. सो वैन योर डॉक्यूमेंट इज प्रिपेयर यू वॉन्ट टू मेक ए हार्ड कॉपी ऑफ इट, देन यू जस्ट डोंट जस्ट ट्राई टू गिव द हार्ड कॉपी ऑफ द, डोंट गिव जस्ट प्रिंट कमांड. एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेक अ प्रिंट प्रिव्यू. प्रिंट प्रिव्यू बेसिकली टेल्स यू दैट हाउ द एक्चुअल हार्ड कॉपी लुक लाइक्स. ओके, सो फॉर दैट पर्पज देर इज ए स्पेशल फंक्शन नेम प्रिंट प्रिव्यू. सो गो टू द प्रिंट प्रिव्यू ऑप्शन, दैट विल टेल यू द प्रिव्यू ऑफ द प्रिंट वट एवर यू गेट आफ्टर द प्रिंट ऑपरेशन. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ प्रिव्यूइंग ऑफ ए डॉक्यूमेंट. सो द क्वेश्चन इज वट डू यू मीन बाई प्रिव्यूइंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट. सो पेज प्रिव्यू मीन्स प्रिव्यूइंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट प्रायर टू बींग प्रिंटेड, एंड दैट इज बींग टू सी हाउ द डॉक्यूमेंट विल एक्चुअली लुक वैन प्रिंटेड. नेक्स्ट इज हाउ आर टेबल्स ऑफ राइटर यूजफुल. सो वी मेक्स अ टेबल इन अ राइटर एंड अदर वर्ड प्रोसेसर ऑल्सो. टेबल ऑर्गेनाइज इंफॉर्मेशन इन रोज एंड कॉलम्स, एंड द वे रोज एंड कॉलम्स आर इंटरसेक्ट दे मेक अ सेल. सो ए टेबल रिप्रेजेंट रिलेटेड नंबर्स, इंफॉर्मेशन और फैक्ट्स इन एन ऑर्गेनाइज वे. टेबल्स कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज टू डिफाइन लिस्ट डेफिनेशंस, ऑर्गेनाइज डेटा एंड आइडियाज और रिकॉर्ड फैक्ट्स. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज वैन डू यू थिंक यूज द बुलेटेड लिस्ट और नंबर लिस्ट इज मोर अप्रोप्रिएट इन अ राइटर डॉक्यूमेंट. So the use of the bulleted list is an effective way to outline or list item of internet in a writer document. We should use bulleted list when the order of the item is unimportant, such as the list of the computer system requirement. We should use the number list when the order of the item is meaningful, such as a list of the step in a process. So the question is, what do you think the use of bulleted list and or numbered list in a more appropriate in a writer document? So there are two types of lists. First of all, these are bulleted list and the numbered list. When items are less, and then in that case we use bulleted list that basically show the number of, which show the important items, okay, such as the computer parts. And when we want to indicate list of different items and items are basically in a huge number, then we make a numbered list, such as the name of the students. Okay, so there are two types of lists, bulleted list and numbered list. And different types of bullets are there, and different types of numbering are also there. Numbering are not only in the integers like 1, 2, 3, 4, but they may be in the forms of letters, such as ABCD, whether it is in capital letter or both in capital letter or in small letter, both are acceptable in that case, and also in Roman, capital as well as small. And different types of bullets is also there. Such type circle, square, okay. So different types of bullets are also there that represent the data in the form of a list. So these are the questions related to your word processor. Now I think you are able to understand all the basic concept of the word processor. So just learn the definitions, okay. Now, these are the some word shortcut keys which are here, and if you want to use these shortcut keys in Microsoft Word, you are able to do your work in a very short interval of time. In this case, when we just write plus sign, that means the combination. So for example, if we want to enter the data and in such a way then all letters are in capital letters, then we use the key Control plus Shift plus A. It means that Control Shift A simultaneously, we press these three keys simultaneously, and we are able to give the data in capital letters, and all letters are in capital. Then apply bullet list, apply list bullet. For that shortcut is Control plus Shift plus L. First of all, if you want to select the data in capital letters, then first of all, if you want to make the data in capital letters, first of all, select the data. For select the data, there is a command Control plus A. First of all, selection is there. After that, you can make all letters in capital letters. So command is Control plus Shift plus A. And for apply bullet list, there is a command Control plus Shift plus L. And for auto format, Control plus Alt plus K. These three key, if you press simultaneously, then your auto format option is enabled. Next is auto text. There is a shortcut key for that, and this is a function key F3. That is a auto text. Next is bold. If you want to make your data bold, first of all select the data, and then after press the key Control plus B. And if you want to cancel the data, then for that purpose, escape key, ESC key is there. If you want to make your paragraph center aligned, then that for that purpose, there is a key, Control plus E. For center alignment, Control plus E. And if you want to change case, then for that purpose, Shift plus F3. Press these two keys simultaneously, and you are able to change your case. And if you want to clear your data, then for that purpose, press delete key. Just after the selection, press delete, and you are able to delete the entire data. Then close or exit. If you want to close your data and if you want to exit the word processor, then Microsoft Word, then for that purpose, there is a key Alt plus F4. And for copy, Control plus C. For copy operation, there is a key Control plus C. And for create auto text, Alt plus F3. If you want to make a cut operation, then Control plus X. And if you want to perform double underline, then for that purpose, Control plus Shift plus D. Control plus Shift plus D means double underline. And next is find. If you want to find something, or find a word in a document, and there is a shortcut Control plus F. Okay. And there's a option available find, in which you can type a word, and you can find that word in your entire document. And there is another option that are available to find, and that is replace. If you want to replace that word with some other text, then you are also able to replace that word. Okay, so for find, that is a Control F. So find and replace, basically both are appears at the same time when you just press Control plus F. And then help, if you have some problem in certain options, and you want some help, then there is a shortcut for that, and the shortcut is F1. So press F1 key. Next is hyperlink. For hyperlink, there is option Control plus K. So using Control plus K option, you are able to create hyperlink. Next is indent. For indent, there is a shortcut Control plus M. If you want to convert your data in italic, then Control plus I. But before applying this, just select the entire data using Control A. Then you are able to convert it in italic font. Next is justify paragraph. So if you want to apply the justify alignment, then there is a shortcut for that, and that shortcut is Control plus J. So Control plus J is the shortcut for justify alignment. And next is merge field. So if you want to merge different fields, then shortcut for that is Alt plus Shift plus F. And if you want to open new document, for that purpose there is a shortcut name Control plus N. And if you want to open a document, then for that purpose there is a shortcut Control plus O. And to make outline, there is a shortcut Alt plus Control plus O. And if you want to overtype, then for that purpose Insert. Okay, for page Alt plus Control plus P, and for page break Control plus Return. If you want to break a page, then for that purpose Control plus Return key. Then next for paste, Control plus V, and with paste there is another option that is available, paste format. Okay, so paste format shortcut is Control plus Shift plus V. Now for print, there is a Control plus P. For print, shortcut key is Control plus P. And for print preview, shortcut key is Control plus F2. So before going to print, we most of the time just press Control plus F2 key to see the preview of that page. After that, we make a printout of that soft copy. So Control plus P is the shortcut for print, and Control plus F2 is the shortcut for print preview. Next is redo. Redo, shortcut for redo is Alt plus Shift plus Backspace. Alt plus Shift plus Backspace, and that is the shortcut key for redo. And for redo or repeat, there is a and the shortcut Control plus Y. Most of the time Control plus Y is written in most of the books. So if any examination, if you want if it is asked that what is the shortcut key for redo, just write Control plus Y. And then save. Okay, for save there is a key Control plus S, save. And there is another question which is asked so many number of time in examination, that what is the difference between save and save as command. Basically both are the same, both are used to save our document. When we just make a new document and just save it using Control plus S command, or go to the save option, you are also able to save your document. Okay, but the basic difference between the save and the save is that when you create a new document, you just save it, and when you want to make a new copy or fresh copy of it, then just perform the save as option. So it will basically create a duplicate of it using and name of the save as is different as the name of when a name of the save when you just apply the save operation. So that is a basic function, basic difference between save and save as. So when we want to make a different name for a same copy of the text, then we just perform save as. And generally we apply save operation to perform the to save our task in a Word document. Next is select all. So select all is already discussed. For select all, there is a key named Control plus A. And if you want to change all letters in small caps, there is a key Control plus Shift plus K. And for style, Control plus Shift plus S. Now some more important keys are there, subscript and superscript. If you want to change your data in subscript, then select the data and press Control plus equal. And if you want to make it in subscript, then just write Control plus Shift plus equal. So these keys are also very important. And these most of the times when you just write a mathematical formula such as 10 to the power 2, or write a chemical formula such as S2 plus O2 is equal to 2S2. So in that case, subscript and superscript are used. And then take pan for that, Control plus F1, and time field. If you want to apply the time field, then Alt plus Shift plus T. For underline, Control plus U. And if you want to undo your data, then Control Z. That is very important. Undo and redo. Control Y plus for redo, and Control Z plus for undo. And for update field, F9 key is there. And if you want to count a word, then word count list, shortcut is Control plus Shift plus G. These are the keys related to Microsoft Word. So thanks for watching this video.